Hello everybody, this is Brachfit at Björnin for Etats Plus, and this is part 3 of the tutorial series about DaVinci Resolve. Today we're gonna speak mostly about the core page. Firstly, we're gonna see how to customize and navigate inside it. Later we're gonna see how to adjust contrast, how to do a primary grid workflow, and how to work with the curves. I'm gonna split the tutorial into 3 parts because it's just gonna be a long one, and I hope you're gonna learn a lot of from it. First of all, I'm gonna start with a simple quick tips about the core page, just to where to find the vector scopes, how to navigate inside the core page, how to customize it, how to customize the user interface, and just some quick simple things that are gonna speed up your work. So let's start. As you can see, I'm already in the core page and I have imported one of the XMLs from the previous tutorials. It's a simple one, not a whole project, but it's exported for the purposes of the tutorial. Let's first talk about the viewer. Inside the viewer, you can see the currently selected clip on the timeline. These are the timelines. This one is the mini timeline. As you can see, we see up to 6 video tracks, but we can always scroll it up and see the rest of them. With the scroll of the mouse or your control interface, you can scroll and zoom in and zoom out the mini timeline, so easily to scroll to the end of the project, end of the timeline. There's a thumbnail timeline, so if I want to select this clip, just click on it and DaVinci will send me to the first frame of the timeline that this clip is on. So as you can see, the mini timeline, it's not the first frame of the clip, but the first frame where this clip is in the timeline shown. So if I scroll one frame before this, I see that already the clip is changed. I see now this clip from the video track number 3. This is the time code, so source time code, record time code, frames in the timeline, record frames, etc, etc. This pop-up, as we said in the previous tutorial, is selecting timelines from the project. And this button here sends us to the enhanced viewer. So it removes the gallery and the nodes, and you can see much easier the viewer. If you want to go back to the normal mode, just click the same button again. The gallery page, it's for your stills and grades. So if you want to grab a still from this clip, just right click on the viewer, grab still, and it's in. This still can be applied to different clips. So if I go to probably this clip here and drag the clip into the nodes, I'm gonna apply the changes from this still to this clip. So this is not the perfect example, but I'm going back here, I'm gonna make some changes, probably some drastic changes like blue. I'm gonna grab a still, I'm gonna remove this, just so. I'm gonna back to this clip and apply the still. As you can see, the same changes have been applied to this node. Just by grabbing Castile and dragging it to the next node, this is the fastest way to applying the same changes. So I'm gonna remove this Castile. I'm gonna Control Z to remove the changes here again, and all the thumbnails have been updated. So this is for the gallery page. DaVinci Resolve is a node-based system, so I have explained what is a node-based system in the text above the video tutorial, but in my first suggestion is to learn all the shortcuts in the nodes, in the color, in the playback, and in the view. As most of the shortcuts, it's gonna speed up your work a lot. In the nodes, you can add a serial node just by Alt S, And as you can see, the note will be applied just behind your previous note and before the output. This is the source and this is the output of the clip. So if I have made some changes to the first note and then go to the second, you can see already everything is just reset and this. And if you want to just see it without the second note, just press Command D. And if you want to see in the view of the clip without all of the notes, just press Alt and D. If you want to delete the note, just right click, delete note. If you want to go back and remove the changes, just press this reset. And everything is okay. This is the note. You can just zoom in. You can use the clip, the track button, etc., etc. This is the mini timeline, the thumbnail timeline, and here are all of our tools for core grading. Most time you're gonna use the primaries or the core wheels, whatever you're used to working. This is the RGB mixer, and here are our curves, qualifier, etc. And you can use this hue versus hue, the hue versus saturation, hue versus luminance, etc. If you're going to use a lot of keyframing, you can click on this button and just stick all of our tools inside one panel and move a lot of place for the keyframe tablet. You can also remove the gallery page and make a lot of space for the notes tab by pressing the same button here. Or if you want to remove the viewer, if you have external calibrated monitor, just press here, right click in the notes, toggle display mode, and the viewer is gone. So toggle display mode again, click this button here again, and the gallery and the viewer are back here. Click this button and the core tools and the secondary tools are already here again. Finally, the feature single window interface. So the only windows that can be sent to a second window. So if you had dual head setup monitors, the only windows that can be sent to the second monitor are the vector scopes. So to show the scopes, just go to the viewer, right click it, and show scopes. As you can see, we have four up scopes. Basically, they are waveform, parade, histogram, and vector scope. And each of them can be customized. So if you go to this button on each of them, I click it and we can change their positions. If I click parade, you see that waveform and parade have switched. Again, the waveform. I can apply grayscale and leave the colors out or bring back the colors. I can switch to remove the red and leave only the blue and green. And I can adjust my brightness and graticule. Or I click outside the adjustment to remove it and just reference level. So if I want to apply probably not extended levels or just apply normal levels, I can adjust them with the low and high. This means that this will not be rendered out. So this is just reference levels. This will not limit my color grade. I'm gonna click outside to remove it, and every single of them can be customized. So if I want my vector scope to be to show the skin tone, I can select it to show the graticule, select it as well, or just as well the brightness. This window can be sent to the second monitor of your dual setup and can be as well extended if you want, And if your monitor is 4x3, you can as well select this, and or if it's 16x9 as well. So these are the scopes. We're gonna talk later about them and how you can use them during your core grading. For now, just know that they can be opened by right-clicking in the viewer, show scopes, and you can send them to your second monitor if you have one, or just leave them here, probably just above your gallery tab. So let's make a short break, and in the second part we're going to talk about the adjusting contrast and primary core adjustment.